Now I am adding trivalent impurity. What is trivalent impurity? Boron. Trivalent impurity, boron. Boron. Boron consists how many electrons? Are 3 electrons. For this intrinsic semiconductor, I am adding boron. See here. Here I am removing the germanium. I am adding there boron. Boron. Boron consists how many electrons? Are 3 electrons. It is a 1 electron. It is second electron. It is third electron. Then what happens? See here, for this boron, here same to same bond takes place. There also same bond takes place. There also same bond takes place. But here there is no electron to form a bond here. Automatically there is no electron. Absence of electron, vacant of electron is there. That absent of electron is called a hole. The absent of electron is called a hole. Now what you are observing? If you add a trivalent impurity to this germanium, what forms a? That forms a hole. That forms a hole. If you add more number of impurities, that results more number of holes. See here, there is no electron to participate a covalent bond. There is no electron. It accepts a electron. That's why trivalent impurities, this trivalent impurities also called as acceptor impurities. Acceptor impurities, acceptors. Why these are called acceptors? Because there is no electron. If you give one electron, that can accept. That is alloying. That's why trivalent impurities are called acceptor impurities. If we add acceptor impurities, what happens? That results a hole. That results a hole. Now, what I am adding, sir? You take a germanium, you are adding a boron. Automatically, that gives a extrinsic semiconductor. Extrinsic semiconductor. That extrinsic semiconductor consists holes. Hole is a positive charge or negative charge? Hole is a positive charge. Hole is a positive charge. That's why this is called as a p-type semiconductor. P-type semiconductor. So extrinsic semiconductor again classified into two types. One is a p-type semiconductor, next one is a n-type semiconductor. Now I am explaining here p-type semiconductor. How p-type semiconductor is forming? Simple. If we add trivalent impurities to germanium or silicon, that gives a p-type. P-type means what, sir? Positive type semiconductor. Why that is called positive type semiconductor? Because their holes forms. Hole has positive charge. That's why that name is a positive type semiconductor. Now I am adding pentavalent impurity. If we add pentavalent impurity, what happens? We have to check. Very simple. Pentavalent impurity example, what, sir? Pentavalent impurity example, phosphorus. Pentavalent impurity example, phosphorus. What is the structure? Initially there we have germanium. There we have 4 electrons like that. Now I am adding pentavalent impurity. Pentavalent. Penta means 5. Pentavalent impurity. What is the example, sir? Phosphorus. Now I am adding phosphorus to that intrinsic semiconductor. Then what happens? We have to check. If I add phosphorus here, phosphorus consists 5 electrons. Here phosphorus there, phosphorus, 5 electrons are there. Check, 1 2 3 4. I have to write one more electron. I have to draw here one more electron. Then what is the electron charge, positive or negative? Electron charge is negative. So what I am getting here? I am getting a electron, extra electron. This is a electron. Previously, if you add boron, you get a hole. But now you are getting electron. Electron charge, plus or minus? Minus. That's why that is called as a n-type semiconductor, negative type semiconductor. How that forms, sir? Simple, take germanium, you are adding phosphorus, 5 electrons you are adding. For pure form of germanium, you are adding phosphorus, impurity you are adding. That results what, sir? Extrinsic semiconductor. Extrinsic semiconductor. In this process, what resulting, in this process, what we are getting? In this process, we are getting electrons. What is the charge of electron? Electron charge is negative. That's why this extrinsic semiconductor name is a n-type semiconductor. Now you tell me, how many types of semiconductors we have? We have generally two types of semiconductors. One is a intrinsic semiconductor. Next one is a extrinsic semiconductor. This intrinsic semiconductor is a pure form. That extrinsic semiconductor is a impure form. Extrinsic semiconductor again classified into two types. One is a p-type semiconductor. Next one is a n-type semiconductor. What is p-type semiconductor? If we add trivalent impurities, we are getting a hole. Hole has positive charge. That's why that name is a p-type semiconductor. Now, what is n-type semiconductor? Take a pure form of germanium, add pentavalent impurities like phosphorus, then that results more electrons. Electrons has negative charge. That's why that name is a n-type semiconductor. Here one electron is extra. Here one electron is extra. See, to form a covalent bond, generally we required 4 electrons. One electron is extra here. That's why pentavalent impurities, also called as donor impurities. Also called as donor impurities. Why donor impurities? Because they can donate one electron. They are ready to donate. That's why pentavalent impurities are called donor impurities and trivalent impurities are called acceptor impurities. So I am drawing a simple diagram. Once again, you check this diagram. Semiconductors are how many types? Semiconductors are two types. Semiconductors are two types. One is a intrinsic semiconductor and next one is a extrinsic semiconductor. Extrinsic semiconductor. What is intrinsic? Pure form. If we add some impurities, if we add some impurities, that results a extrinsic semiconductor. How many types of impurities we have? We have two types of impurities. One is a trivalent impurity and next one is a pentavalent impurity. Pentavalent impurity. If you add trivalent impurity, that is a trivalent. Tri means three. One is less. One is less. That is results p-type semiconductor. Pentavalent impurity, that results n-type semiconductor. So extrinsic semiconductors again classified into two types. One is a p-type semiconductor. Next one is a n-type semiconductor. P-type semiconductor and n-type semiconductor.